Hi everyone, welcome back to Swiss Home Garden. Chitra here. In this video, I will be taking you along our July garden and harvest. This summer has been one of the coldest summers since 80 years. Probably there's not much to harvest. What we will be harvesting will be some of the perennials and some of the seasonals which we planted very early on in spring. We haven't been much out in the garden due to the constant rain. If you have been following the news in Europe, you would have noticed that many of the countries were flooded and there was a lot of damage and a lot of death too. Despite us having a creek in our garden and in our plot, we were lucky to escape it. About 3 years back, we had a really bad summer storm and we were all flooded. But it was fortunately for a very short time, only our cellar was a little bit flooded. This year, we were lucky, we didn't have any water so far. But it has been a real struggle with the weather. We haven't been out much in the garden and we were very busy also with other projects. We are first harvesting the peas which we planted early spring. This year we planted the peas in the earlier potato patch. Since potato cannot be planted in the same patch every year, we thought we will increase the nitrogen content in our soil by planting peas in that area. We got a couple of kilograms of peas and I used them nicely for our cooking, but it was not that big an yield. Mainly because it was so wet and rainy, we didn't have much time to de-weed in between, so they outgrew and finally it was time to harvest them. I made this video about a couple of weeks back and I'm quite late in editing it because it's also summer holidays and we are busy otherwise. Next, we will be harvesting our annuals, that is red currants. But first, we'll have to get through to that patch and we have to clear up these thorns. And you cannot get through to the fairy garden anymore because all these thorns had overgrown and we'll have to clear them up first. My husband lost a little bit of inspiration this summer, mainly because it has been constantly raining and cloudy, and I think many of them have the same problem. So let's hope that next year at least it will be better, or at least we can plant something for the fall this year. This is supposed to be some kind of berry, but so far it hasn't given any fruits. So we will be cleaning up around it and wait for the fruits. And here is our red currant bush. The yield has tripled this year and I have made at least about 20 bottles of red currant jelly, and I made a couple of bottles of syrup and I've been eating them when they were ripe. I will leave the link below for the recipes I have shared so far in my blog and also in this channel. Red currants are very rich in vitamin C and they are also looking like grapes. I think in some parts of Europe they also call it as red grapes. They are a little bit astringent in taste but very high in pectin content. So if you are going to be making a jelly or a jam, you don't need to be adding pectin sugar to it. On the other hand, if I have to make a syrup with this, I'll have to remove out the pulp and not let it strain too strongly, otherwise it becomes a jelly. We had a couple of big harvests like this, and I ate quite a lot of it before I could even process them. I usually let them stay on the kitchen counter for a couple of days to further ripen before I started to process them. These flowers are from the leek. Since we didn't harvest all the leeks, we let them grow and we couldn't get to the garden anyway so often. But I found out that this has been attracting the bees, and we need a lot of bees. So we will be collecting the seeds from these leeks to plant for next season. We didn't plant zinnia this year. In the front yard, we had a lot of zinnias last year and they were attracting a lot of bees, and a few zinnias in the backyard, but somehow we forgot to plant them during the early spring months. We had a relatively good strawberry harvest season, and after the first season, we will have to trim them to get a second season in autumn. And this is one of our compost bins for garden weeds and all the excess that we cut out from the garden. The silvery grayish bushes are the sea buckthorn berries. Here we had planted some garlics and we will be harvesting them. Some of them had stayed back from last year. We didn't harvest all of it because they didn't grow very well, so we let them grow and now we can harvest them. It's not a huge yield, but that's sufficient for this year. While harvesting, he found this huge snail, so we will be putting it back in there. Despite the wet weather, we didn't have that many slugs because we have a creature in our garden which is eating up the slug eggs. So we are a little bit better off this year from the slug attacks than the previous years. Our salad bed has also survived well because of that creature eating up all the slugs. Let's move on to the salad bed. In between the salad bed, we have also planted some beans. These are the scripper beans, and we could give it some kind of support with our own OCS, which we trimmed in winter. They are doing well so far, but I'm yet to see any beans. Usually around this time, we should be able to harvest some beans, but there were too many cloudy days and it was too wet. At the rear of the salad bed, you can also see some more of these lettuces. We are harvesting now and then something from it, but it's already too old and they don't taste as good. They're quite bitter at this stage, so we will be taking them out. This flower over here is carrots. We planted these carrots last year, and if we leave a couple of them to the second year, then they will start to give flowers and then we can collect the seeds from them. Let's move on towards the greenhouse. This creeper inhabiting the wall of this greenhouse is the cucumbers. We planted this year the smaller salad cucumbers, which we can ferment or even can. And we forgot to plant the nostrano. I love the nostrano. This doesn't have much taste unless you can. So far I got a few, but not that many. We are harvesting these cherry tomatoes every day, and we are getting quite a bit now. We mix it into the salads, and I also cook with them because I have so much of it. I will be fermenting in the next few days. They are the perfect size for us to ferment. And if there is really a lot more yield, maybe I will can a few. On the other hand, the zucchinis are doing well. We could harvest quite a few zucchinis. I like to bake them. And this patch over here is the potato patch. I have shared a video on how to plant potatoes and how to care for them and how to harvest them. This is the other tomato bed, but since it was really cold and very few sunny days, they are not thriving that well. It's already end of July as I'm recording this voiceover, but we are yet to see anything out of it. And this plant over here is the sunflowers. These come automatically every year. We have a few of them, but this year has not been that many. With this, I end my tour and video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and thank you for watching. If you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe. I post one new video every week on food from scratch, Swiss country living, gardening, and natural recipes. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.